Neuromorphism, also known as soft UI, is a trend in UI design that emerged at the beginning of 2020. It uses highlights and shadows to make UI elements appear as if they were floating above the surface. And you might have noticed that neuromorphism design looks very similar to the bevel and emboss effect in, for example, Photoshop. Basically, neuromorphism is the new version of popular skeuomorphism design trend, which makes UI elements resemble real-life objects with shadows and highlights, etc. Let's have a closer look at the origins of neuromorphism. One of the first examples of neuromorphism was a concept design posted on Dribbble by Alexander Pluto, and I hope that I pronounced it right, and I'm sorry if I didn't. So, it was instantly picked up by other designers, and since then, the internet pretty much became flooded with more neuromorphism concepts, tutorials, and even products like UI kits and CSS libraries. But does this mean that you should use neuromorphism for a real project? Well, not quite. Despite it being very popular at the moment, one of the co-creators of the term neuromorphism, Michael Malevich, believes that it's not going to stay, and gives several reasons why using neuromorphism in your website's interface is not a good idea. Well, firstly, neuromorphism is not versatile enough to be popular as a design style, especially in real projects. Also, it doesn't work for buttons because the change of state is not visible enough, especially for people with visual impairments or those who have lower quality screens or lower screen contrast. Cards and sliders are probably the best use cases for neuromorphism. However, there is a number of conditions for it to work. The structure of the card must be done right. The element's hierarchy needs to be clear and the spacing well defined. The best way to test if the card works is by removing the neuromorphic background. If it works on its own, especially next to other cards, it's good. How to use neuromorphism right? If you're thinking about using neuromorphism, start with some opportunities that will let you try it out and get a feel for what works and what doesn't. Make your design accessible. Run tests to see what works for your users and use an approach that lets you easily change your mind. So what types of projects will neuromorphism work for? Well, it might work for single page apps and small projects. When you're working with a design project that has a relatively small scope, iterating your design is pretty straightforward. But it's a no for complex websites and apps. If you're still going to use neuromorphism for a complex website, make sure it will be possible to apply some changes later. Because even if UX testing found that your users are responding positively to neuromorphism today, it's quite possible that they'll find it irritating to deal with after 6 months. Time will tell if neuromorphism is a temporary trend or it's here to stay. Sound off in the comment section if you have used or intend to use soft UI in your projects. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos and Elementor tutorials. See you next time!